challenge is that the focus that the Philippines has been given in terms of the benchmark of innovation is something that is against their natural skills or what they are good at. And why do I say this? You know, I give an example of industries that I have seen very good innovation, and that's why I was asking the questions. One of them is the furniture industry in the Philippines, which is quite amazing in relation to other countries in the world. I have lived in different countries and I've worked in different countries, and some of the produce that comes from places like Cebu is quite amazing. The other thing is in the food industry. You know, when you see local companies like Jollibee coming up and being able to compete against McDonald's, that is innovation there.
And beat McDonald's.
In itself, and beat it, right? And that's innovation. The other area is in fashion, right? I think what I'm trying to say is that not everybody can be science and technology expert. You know, yes, you do need them. But again, you know, yes, it's much more easier to be innovative on your strengths than to focus on trying to mitigate your weaknesses. And, you know, I do understand, yes, the education system or the culture may not be conducive to science, technology, maths, and things like that, but it should have a balanced approach, right? I mean, don't neglect completely and say let's not focus on fashion or food and things like that, but more of a balanced approach. And I think that's what I have seen from my own